Today we are talking about workout format. So you already got through the motivation video. You kind of should have an idea of why you're doing this. You kind of watched through your SMART goals and hopefully took some time to set up some specific goals that you're going to work towards. And we'll see how we modify those as we go. The next step that I want to take you into is the workout format. How do I set up the workouts that I do so that you can know exactly what to expect? My workouts are broken up into five essential sections. They are the warm-up, the dynamic stretching, the workout, the cool down, and the static stretching. Let's get started. First up, the warm up. Why do it? Well, it's pretty simple. It protects you from injury. It also gets your muscles a little bit ready for the exercises you're about to do. Second question, how do you do it? Seriously, this one's pretty straightforward. You just go for a 5 to 10 minute jog. I personally do these as a part of my actual training. So when I'm starting my workout, I just go for that 5 to 10 minute jog and then go straight into the exercises that I'm gonna do. Section number two are dynamic stretches. I'm a huge fan of dynamic stretching. Dynamic stretches are stretches that you do that quickly move your body into the motions that you're about to be doing, and they also serve to help you warm you up. Dynamic stretches are basically like high knees, butt kicks, soldiers, sweepers, strides, and I'm gonna walk you through those in a later video, but I wanted you to at least hear them now so that when you hear them again, it won't be the first time. Sometimes in part of my warm up and my dynamic stretching, I also do rolling. There are lots of different rollers on the market. I'm gonna have an entire separate video for that. But for the sake of the workout, just know that sometimes I include rolling just if I'm injured or if I'm just trying to warm those muscles up a little bit more before I get into this specific workout that I'm doing. One of the benefits of rollers is they really let you isolate some pressure points that are going on in your muscles. If you have knots or if you have some sort of tightness, you can really zone in on those. And that's one reason that I do rolling if I have injuries or something like that. The next section is the workout itself, and that's pretty straightforward, right? It's gonna range all over the place. So I don't wanna jump into this too much. Just know it could take 10 minutes, it could take an hour and a half or 2 hours, depending on the workout that you're doing. And that's just all part of the process of growing as a runner, is diving into those workouts. This is where your main focus should be during the exercise. Next up is your cool down. The cool down is so important when you're running. A lot of people just throw this one out. I really heavily recommend it. If you will just take a few minutes, 5 to 10 minutes even, to just kind of jog out at the end or even walk out. Sometimes I'll make sure to start my workout just a quarter mile from home, just so I have that last quarter mile that I have to walk in. It kind of forces me to slow down right. One of the benefits of the cool down is it helps your muscles return to that natural homeostasis so they don't get over tight from just immediately stopping. Kind of eases you into it. And last, guys, we have our static stretching. Static stretching is really good for injury prevention if you have over tightness in your legs or in other parts of your body. I personally don't do a lot of static stretching once I get into my program. When I was actually finishing up my last season of training, I didn't stretch for over 6 months and I was doing the best running I've ever done. But my muscles had been completely prepared and refined for that process. So I didn't need to do a ton of stretching. The main reason to do stretching is to have the flexibility that you need for the motion that you're doing. And a lot of times, especially runners, we overstretch those muscles and those ligaments because we don't need them to do those crazy extended ranges of motion when you're out there running. You just need to make that stride length. So be careful about overstretching in this area. I personally recommend not static stretching until after you have done your workout. With all that being said, I sometimes will roll out after the workout as well, and that's sometimes how I'll finish it. I'll just spend some time rolling out different muscles if I have that tightness or those little knots building up or some soreness in there. It kind of helps flush some things out. Basically, all my workouts are structured this way. So if you see in a thing that it only lists the workout, like run 2 miles, understand that there is a presupposition that you will be doing the warm up, the cool down in all of that. Okay, maybe you work it into the workout before or after, those kinds of things. So remember, as we work through this, as always, please make sure you're setting those goals, make sure you're staying consistent in those goals, and I promise you, we will make this happen.